Hi, we are PolyOrbite, a Canadian student engineering team from Polytechnique Montreal. We are pleased to show you our system acceptance review for URC 2024. It is our third rover iteration, which has been significantly improved and the most important one yet. This year, we decided to put our focus on operational readiness, testing, reliability, and proper system integration. We hope to participate in URC 2024 to continue to improve ourselves and succeed internationally.
Our main goal was to make the system more custom-made to allow for easier integration of the different modules. The rover is equipped with a 24-volt lithium-ion battery designed by our electrical team. The battery is then stepped down and redirected to other modules such as motor drivers using our custom-made power distribution PCBs. The battery is protected by a BMS, and the system is also equipped with a kill switch which allows to completely shut the power off to the rover. Our electrical team is currently working on designing a fully custom-made electronic system to drive the rover. The system is equipped with a kill switch which allows to cut the power off while maintaining the communication with the rover's computer. Our electrical team is currently designing a video multiplexer to optimize bandwidth. We also completely redesigned the cable management and electronic placement of the robotic arm
with our third version rocker buggy suspension, which is now lighter and sturdier to allow it to traverse rough terrains. The rover has custom TPU 3D printed wheels for which the traction has been optimized.
The drone is currently powered by motors able to output about 30 kilograms of thrust. The drone can fly autonomously when given GPS coordinates. And with our newly added RTK GPS system, we are now precise within 10 centimeters.
The rover is controlled through our own custom-built interface. The antennas that we use are on a 2.4 gigahertz frequency. One of them is placed on our ground station, and there is another one on the rover, which is omnidirectional. So this year we did a full simulation of the rover. This allowed us to test different modules, and we noticed that there was no significant drop in their performance. We are currently exploring different antenna modes and different frequencies, like 900 megahertz frequency and 5 gigahertz frequency, in order to have better camera streaming capabilities.
For the science task, we almost entirely redesigned our sampling system. The drill can currently go down 12 centimeters deep. Then the sampler, with its claw and sensor, measures the temperature and humidity at the bottom of the holes and samples 10 grams of dirt. It then carries a sample to a carousel where we can analyze it with a pH test for the presence of phosphate as well as carbonate molecules. At each site, the rover will take a panorama shot of its surroundings. For the drilling test, we have currently been able to sample snow and loose soil.
Our drone will be controlled using ArduPilot and in the future will be integrated with ROS2 to communicate directly with the rover.
So for the equipment servicing mission, we designed Karma with versatility in mind. With its high reach and also its six-axis design, it can adapt to a wide variety of situations such as latch opening and joystick operation. We added the ROS Move It package to the arms control system to add some inverse kinematics to allow us to have a greater precision. During the winter semester, we are doing tests every week to ensure that all of our different pilots are able to overcome the challenges. During this task, the arm is able to open boxes and manipulate different objects.
So for the autonomous navigation mission, we employ SLAM in order to localize and map the rover's route. The sensors used to locate the rover are the GPS and the IMU. These coordinates are later refined by using the Hangsville open source dataset and the wheel odometry. The mapping of the rover's environment is made possible by using the RP LiDAR and the library cartographer in order to produce a heat map of the environment. Each camera stream is passed through a filter, allowing for the rover to detect any error codes on the post. We are currently working on a YOLO model to detect any of the objects which will figure around the post on the navigation mission. In order to control autonomously the rover, we use the NAV2 stack, which allows to place a goal node using GPS coordinates and allowing to create a path for the rover to navigate to those GPS coordinates. Sensor inputs have been tested and are functional on a simulation on Gazebo. For the delivery mission, our high resolution cameras allow us to read signs, search for objects, and identify geological interest points. Currently operating at more than 900 meters, with our new antenna of 900 megahertz, we will be sure to operate beyond line of sight.
I am extremely proud of my team and everything we've accomplished so far. As you can see, we are ready for URC. We thank you for your consideration and hope to see you in May. Thank you.